In this episode of The Amazing Race, we're going to take a close, personal look at what it's like to be the parent of a prodigal child, one that's not walking in the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ. Here we have the Smith family. Isaac and Rachel are Christians who love the Lord and are going to church as many Sundays as they possibly can. Here's Jacob. He's married now with a family of his own, but since college, he's walked away from the Lord.
I have a wife and kids that I'm very proud of. I'm a good father, a good husband. I'm a good guy. I still believe in God and all that stuff, but I don't go to church. I don't know what the big deal is.
For this leg of the race, they'll need to call Jacob and invite him to church this Sunday.
Jacob, it's me, son. It's Dad. How you doing?
Hey, Dad. How's it going?
It's going good, son. Hey, listen, I was wondering if you'd be willing to join your mom and I at church this Sunday.
I don't think so, Dad. I plan with the family this Sunday and ready now for the day.
Well, how about next Sunday?
I don't think we can make it.
Well, you know, I wish you'd just think about how bad it looks for your mom and I to be there when everyone else's kids is there.
I gotta go. Kids are here. We'll talk later.
It doesn't look good for Isaac and Rachel. Will they be able to get through to their kids and bring them to church? Maybe another method would be more beneficial.
Well, with this, we're gonna close for tonight. But do we have any prayer requests?
Yes. I have a request. I would really appreciate it if you could talk to Jacob and his wife next time you see them. And you could tell him the importance of coming to church.
Rachel, honey, let me ask you a question. Do you really think this is the best way to go about this?
Of course. If Jacob hears people talking to him about church, he has to listen, right?
Have you really prayed about this? Have you asked for God's guidance? You know, when you gave your prayer request, it was really an order. I can just imagine how Jacob must feel as an adult. There has to be some love and caring in it. The Lord has given us freedom whether to go to church or not.
You know, I know you mean well, but have you put God first in this? Have you sought Him for guidance? Have you prayed for Jacob and his wife?
I was too busy trying to play God than actually listening to him.
May I make a suggestion to you? Why don't you give Jacob an invitation to family camp? Let him think about it.
I think I know what we need to do.
Well, let's see if Isaac and Rachel learned anything from their fellow believers. Before they even begin, Isaac and Rachel stop.
Jacob, how are you? Good to see you, son.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Come on in.
We missed you. How are you?
Come on in.
Doing good, doing good.
How are the kids?
Good.
You know, I want to share with you something that's been weighing on my heart, and I feel I need to apologize to you for attempting to force church down your throat. You know, I didn't mean anything by it.
Dad, I know it's important and to you, and it's not a big deal. You don't have to ever.
I know, but I still feel like I have to. Okay, so I know you don't want to go to church right now, and that's fine, but would you be interested in going to family camp?
Oh, son, it's going to be this great place. It's a place of worship, and everybody worships differently. I think you'll enjoy it, your wife, the kids. Won't you come?
And you'll have fun, too.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
yes.
Mm-hmm. Sounds interesting. Tell me more.
You finally decided to put God first in all things. still in the race.
Yes! Hey.